The M4 Sherman medium battle tank was one of the most iconic fighting vehicles of World War II, and a defining image of the American Army in Europe. Sherman tanks were produced in greater numbers than any other tank in American history. The Sherman 75mm gun was housed in a new, fully traversing top turret, which was derived from the lower hull and running gear of the M3 medium tank. In late 1942, the first models saw combat in North Africa. The original 75mm M3 gun on the Sherman tank was a decent multi-purpose weapon. The 75mm is often cited as barely being a cannon, and closer to a howitzer in terms of barrel length. It had good high explosive capabilities against towed anti-tank positions, bunkers and machine gun nests. It could take on any other tank that they encountered for most of the war. The 75mm gun was sufficient against the earlier, lightly armored tanks it was encountering, such as the Panzer III and IV, and the Stug, and there was a far larger need for equipment to destroy concrete bunkers. However, when it came to heavy German armor, the 75mm gun was unimpressive, and the gun must be used up close to disable German big cats by penetrating the weak side armor. The upgunning of the Sherman from a 75mm to a 76mm cannon was a response to the increased armor found on heavier German tanks such as the Tiger and the Panther. Sherman tanks with 76mm M1 cannons arrived in the UK for testing in early 1944. These tanks would be deployed in greater numbers by late 1944 to early 1945. The 76mm offered far superior armor penetration than the original 75mm gun on the M4 Sherman. The 76mm M1 was distinguished primarily by its longer barrel. It also chambered cartridges with increasingly sophisticated propellant, allowing it to achieve higher muzzle velocity. This higher velocity, along with a slightly heavier shell, provided the M1 cannon with the penetrating power to fight Panthers and Tigers at acceptable combat distances. When using high-velocity armor-piercing or HVAP rounds, the 75mm guns were able to penetrate 4 to 4.5 inches of armor at nearly 1,000 meters. The same rounds used in the 76mm gun could penetrate 6 to 7 inches of armor, and this was enough to take on the front armor of the Tiger tanks. The M1 was also more accurate than the M3 gun. All of this made it a very effective weapon at attacking hard targets like tanks. However, the use of HVAP ammunition eventually became a drawback during World War II. These shells had tungsten surrounded by lighter aluminum. These materials became hard to find close to the end of the war, leaving the shells in short supply. One of the reasons why the 76mm didn't become a universal upgrade on all Shermans was that it used a less effective HE round than the 75mm. When it came to high explosive shells, the 76mm HE shells were not as powerful as the 75mm shells. The charge on the 76mm shell was 0.86 pounds, whereas the charge on the 75mm shell was 1.47 pounds. This made the 76mm less satisfactory for infantry support roles, which is how the Shermans were being used at the time. This reduction in the charge was caused by the necessity for thicker shell walls. The thicker walls allowed the HE shells to be fired from high-velocity guns like the 76mm, but reduced the charge that could be housed. The M1's somewhat larger ammunition resulted in a slightly smaller capacity. In comparison to the M3 gun, the M1 gun was deployed without a smoke round, had a far less effective high-explosive cartridge, and had more barrel smoke. As a result of the drawbacks, many tank commanders and crew continue to view the 75mm as being the better option of the two cannons. Even units in the European theater of operations that were mostly armed with M1 cannons kept one or two M4s with the 75mm gun on hand for anti-infantry and smoke screening purposes. The replacement of a 75mm cannon for the 76mm one was not an easy process, as the entire cannon turret would need to be replaced. The true viability of the 76mm cannon would only develop after World War II. Overall, 76mm guns barely made up half of the American M4 forces by the end of the war. The two guns worked well together, and their use in mixed formations was extensively recorded. If you have enjoyed the video, please subscribe and support the channel for more. Many thanks for watching.